Hello everyone, myself Afsha, high school teacher and English lecturer at Elizabeth High School and Junior College. Welcome back to my class. In our previous class, we have completed part B of our fourth unit of class 10. Now let us proceed towards the part C, that is a tribute. So what's the meaning of tribute? Tribute is to say or do something in order to admire someone. Okay, so it is a tribute. Let us see what is there. The Indian film industry has completed 100 years in the year 2013. So in the year 2013, Indian film industry has completed 100 years, that is a century. It means that it was started in the year 1913. It is a fitting tribute to the world of cinema to recollect our favorite films, producers, directors, actors and music and art directors, right? Telugu audiences are proud of many great producers, directors and artists. So Telugu audience are proud of many artists, directors and producers and etc. Savitri is one such prestigious artist. So now let us proceed towards a character whose name is Savitri, about whom the lesson is given. The protagonist of the story. Ever since she was 8, she evinced interest in learning dance. Later, she associated herself with the theater. She formed a theater organization as well. So, when she was just 8 years old only, she got interested in dancing. It means that she was an artist by birth. She had little difficulty in entering the film field. When Savitri was 12, she was offered a role in the film Agni Pariksha, but was finally dropped as she looked too young for the role. So what happened? When she was just 8 years old, she got interested in dancing, right? Again, when she was 12 years old, she got the opportunity to work in a movie by name Agni Pariksha. But later on, she was dropped because she was looking too young for the role. So she did not fitted in that role actually. She was given a song sequence, Ranante Rane Ranu, in Patala Bhairavi. Savitri's part in it was brief, but the effect of her performance was considerable. Her expressions were beautiful. A lot of filmmakers recognized a potential artist in her. So, after that, what happened? She was given an opportunity to dance in a sequence whose name was Ranante Rane Ranu. She was having a very brief role in it, very short role in it, but she has given her best. So many of the film industry people has appreciated her. As a result, she was elevated to the role of heroine by the noted director L.V. Prasad in the film Samasaram. So it was the first movie in which Savitri got the opportunity to work, whose name was Samasaram. This was the movie which was directed by L.V. Prasad in the year 1950. On the sets, she was nervous. She had to repeat many takes and this proved a setback for her. The role was given to someone else and she was given a small role of less import. So what happened? As it was her first movie, she was very nervous and she was unable to give her best in that. Because of that reason, her role was slashed by someone else and she was given a very small role to play in it. In the film Devadasu, that was released in the year 1953, it is one of the best picture actually of Sarat Chandra Chatterjee's novel Devdas. Parvati comes alive in Savitri. The young Parvati with curly hair, a lock of hair straying to her forehead, the large round blackberry eyes looking out from an innocent face left an indelible imprint in the minds of all sign lovers. She portrayed Devdas' love and the role of a rich man's wife marvelously. Savitri left her mark in this evergreen Telugu classic. So what happened? At first, what happened in the year 1950? It was a bad time of Savitri, we can say. But again, she gave a comeback in the year 1953 by the movie Devadasu, in which she played a role of Parvati, a wife of a young man, in which she portrayed her role in a very best way, right? She got many appreciations from different cine lovers, that is movie lovers, we can say. And she left a mark in this evergreen Telugu classic. Savitri established her credentials with Ardhangi. She gave an exceptionally brilliant performance as a woman forced to marry a mentally retarded person. She nurses him back to health. She also teaches a lesson to her in-laws who conspire against her husband. She inspired public by giving a good role in the movie Ardhangi. That was released in the year 1955, again 2 years later we can say, in which she played a role of a wife of a mentally retarded person. She played a role of a lady who got married forcefully, right? Later on, what she did? She acted as a nurse to her husband. She treated him. Then she gave a lesson to her in-laws. So this was a very inspirational movie about women empowerment, right? So that also left a good mark on the public. Savitri captured the audiences with her charm and magnificent acting. She was able to convey a wide range of feelings through her expressive eyes. So it was her good quality or character, we can say, that she was able to express her expressions very beautifully by her broad eyes. Her mischievous look, it captivates everyone. The look of fake anger provokes. The look filled with real anger pierces the heart. The look of passion while waiting for her lover. The painful look when her love fails. The confident look that seems ready to face any situation. All these myriad emotions are hidden in her eyes. The dimensions are endless and pages can be filled to describe the magic spell of her eyes. So it was the description of her beautiful eyes, right? By which she used to express all the feelings of love, hatred, anger and etc. So she used to express it very beautifully by her broad eyes. Savitri's amazing talent was in full form in Maisamma. So again, a comedy movie it is. A hit comedy that established Savitri's place firmly as a star. Mary in the film comes into an agreement with a Hindu youth, M.T. Rao, that is NTR actually, to pretend as a couple in order to get a job in a school. Mary was a Christian to the core, whereas Rao was a tolerant Hindu. What results in is a 3-hour pure comedy for the audience. So what's the story actually? A lady, right? A heroine who was a Christian by religion, by caste, whose name was Mary, right? Was supposed to act in a false married life, right? In order to get a job in a school, right? She comes to an agreement of marriage with M.T. Rao, that is the role played by NTR. So this was just a comedy movie. The people used to laugh for 3 hours continuously. Savitri was at odd for the matchless ease in expression. Meena Kumari, the heroine of Hindi film, said, "When I watch Savitri's acting, I usually get doubts about my own acting. Her strikingly expressive eyes and her superb sense of timing made her one of the greatest actresses." Amitabh Bachchan felt Savitri was one of the first actress with unbelievable spontaneity. So what it is saying here, not only the general or common audience, but other film stars also. For example, Meena Kumari and Amitabh Bachchan were also very much inspired by Savitri. Meena Kumari used to say that, "I get a doubt on my acting after watching her expressions," right? And Amitabh Bachchan used to say that she is one of the first actress with unbelievable spontaneity, continuity in her acting. Maya Bazaar is another film that brought fame to Savitri. She played the role of Sashi Rekha, recollecting the 16 Annas Telugu lass clad in Parikini. In the song, Alibili Ammaiki reminds us of the rich Telugu culture. So again, she got fame from the film Maya Bazaar. I hope you all remember about the Maya Bazaar that we have learnt in our previous class, right? So in that we have learnt about Shashi Rekha Parinam, right? So that role was played by Savitri only. Again, she got full of reputation by that role. She played a role of a Telugu Ammai, right? Fully Telugu cultural Ammai actually. In the final part of the film, Savitri plays the role of Maya, that is not real. What is the meaning of Maya? That is fiction, as we can say, that is imaginary. Shashi Rekha, right? Ghatotkacha in disguise. She walks in a masculine manner, imitating the legendary S.V. Rangarao acting as Ghatotkacha in the film to perfection. So this was the roles played in Maya Bazaar by Savitri. That was very much inspiring and outstanding, we can say. The theatre rocks with laughter when Lakshmana Kumara Rilangi is teased by Maya Shashi Rekha. She switches from the feminine to the masculine in the twinkling of an eye, and needless to say, a female artist displaying masculine demon qualities with a club in a hand has no parallel. So she even played a role of masculine gender, male, we can say, the male actors, right? So it is highly appreciable that a lady, a female actress, is playing a role of masculine gender. Savitri gets totally involved in whatever role she plays, that is Chivaraku Migiledi in one such film. Chivaraku Migiledi means Chivaraku in the sense at last, right? Migiledi means remained. So is one such film. She played the role of a nurse in a psychiatry ward. In a particular scene, the nurse has a nervous breakdown and cries uncontrollably. The shot was over. cut, the director said, but Savitri, who played the role, could not stop crying. Everyone in the set had to run to her and pacify her. The film became a milestone in her career. So, it was a common habit of Savitri to get totally involved into the character that she is going to play. Right? It has given the example in the movie, that is Chivaraku Migledi. She was supposed to play a role of a nurse in a psychiatric department. According to the scene, according to the script, she was supposed to cry. She was expected to cry of shock at one scene actually. But even after the shot was over, right, when director said cut also, Savitri did not stop her cry. She was still crying, right? It means that she was completely involved in the character. Everyone in the set had to run to pacify her, to console her, right? The film became a milestone in her career. Savitri was awarded the title Mahanati, the supreme artist. So, a title was given to Savitri, that is Mahanati, that is a supreme actress, great actress we can say. She also received the Presidential Award for her performance in Chivaraku Migledi. The magnum opus of Savitri, she was the recipient of Kalaimamani and Nadiyagar Tilakam from Tamil film industry. Savitri had nearly 300 films to her credit. Her career was nearly 30 years long. She was equally admired by Telugu and Tamil film lovers. She also acted in a few Kannada and Hindi films. She had a lion's share of films when she was at the zenith of her career. Her passion for films was so strong that she directed and produced a few films in spite of certain adversities. So what it is saying here now, at first she was given the title as Mahanati and she also received Presidential Award for her performance in Chivaraku Migledi. Not only that award, but she got many other awards for that movie. Her career remained for 30 years long. Right? It's too lengthy actually. And she have made almost 300 films in her career. 300 successful films we can say. Famous or popular films we can say. And in spite of being an actress, she also directed and produced many films because she was having lot of interest in film industry. Just see how much passionate she was about her work, right? She loved her profession actually. Savitri was a human artist. She was generous to the people who were in need. Once, she donated all the jewelry she was wearing to the Prime Minister's fund. Her rise as a star was like a meteor. She left the year in the year 1981, leaving an envied and unsurpassed legacy behind her. So, what it is saying here, she was a very human artist, right? Full of humanity, full of politeness and humbleness. She was generous to the people who were in need. She always used to help the needy people. Once what happened, she donated all her jewelry that she was wearing to the PM CARES fund, okay? So, her rise as a star was as a meteor, we can say, right? And unfortunately, she left the world in the year 1981. It was a great loss to the film industry as well as we Indians because we lost one of our gems. Paying tribute to her, the director and producer Dasari Narayana Rao said, many artists are forgotten soon after the death, but it is not so with Savitri. She will be remembered as long as celluloid lives on. So what it is saying here, paying tribute to Savitri, the director and the producer by name Dasari Narayana Rao said that we may forget many actors and actresses after their death, but Savitri will always remain in our hearts, right? And he also added that she will be remembered as long as celluloid lives on, that is till the day of judgment we can say. All her films would amount to an album of life due to the range of themes. They encompass the human lives and passions in their fully diversity. What is cinema? Is it a fiction or a reality? Many people say many things, but Savitri gave a different definition. She said that cinema is life. Life is eternal. So is cinema, because life runs through it. And Savitri is eternal since she gave that life to cinema. So many people think that cinema is a reality or a fiction, right? But Savitri used to say that cinema is life and life is eternal. Eternal is something that is permanent, okay? So cinema is also permanent according to Savitri. And because of that, we can consider Savitri as eternal since she gave the life to cinema. So this was all about the lesson in which the passion towards the profession of Savitri has been beautifully picturized, right? I hope you all have understood and enjoyed the lesson. Let us continue in our next class. Thank you.